15 people already. Most warm welcome. It is indeed a great pleasure to have all of you here today for this pharmacist public webinar, where we shall be looking at the curtain raiser for the 59th National Pharmacy Week celebrations. We have esteemed dignitaries joining us very shortly. Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, National President of Indian Pharmaceutical Association. We have Dr. Pramod Kumar, who is the principal of JSS College of Pharmacy and the president of the IPA at Mysuru branch. We also have the third main speaker with Dr. Mohammad Salahuddin ji. You are all aware he is the dynamic principal of Farukia College of Pharmacy and at the same time the vice president of IPA Mysuru unit. So let me continue until the numbers stabilize. Friends, in faraway land, I will tell you all an interesting story. There was a guru. Now this Baba or guru, he was known as dialogue guru because he was not a person who will give you an answer to the question you ask. As soon as you ask him a question or you face a doubt, he will start having a dialogue with you. And through dialogue, he will give you some interesting insights. That was his wisdom transfer method. One day, a very young guy went and met this guru, and then he had his own doubts. So he asked him, how to achieve success? That time, guru asked him, why do you want to achieve success? It's a big headache. Why do you want success? That time, the young man said, Babaji, I think failure will not give happiness. Success gives happiness. So I want to know how to become a successful individual, Babaji. Please explain to me. Then Guruji said, okay, let us see how to generate success. And then he asked him a question. Were you comfortable with the thought that you are coming to this ashram or this hermitage? So he asked him, now that you have come to the hermitage, were you comfortable with the thought? Were you comfortable? Okay. Then he said, yes. Then, did you catch the bus? Did you walk from the bus stop till the auto stand? Again catch the auto, then walk up till the hermitage, up to the ashram? So again he said, yes, Babaji, this is how I did it and that is how I came. Then he asked, did you ask for some directions because you did not know the way? And did people help you by giving directions to this ashram or to this hermitage? To this, the boy said, yes, 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 to all the three questions. That time, the Babaji said to him, then you have the success formula with you. Why are you worried? He was stunned. What do you mean that I have got the success formula with me? I am really confused, Babaji. Please explain to me. You asked me whether I was comfortable thinking of coming to this ashram. I said yes. And then did I walk? Did I catch the bus? Did I catch the auto? I said yes. And then did I ask for the route to this place? I said yes. And now you are telling me that I know the answer, that I know how to become a successful individual. That time Babaji said, yes, yes, you know how to become successful. So the elaboration goes this way. He said, if you are comfortable with the thought that you are coming to this hermitage, that means you have self-esteem, which means you are comfortable with the goal that you have decided. So since you are comfortable with the goal that you have decided, it means you are having some self-love, some self-esteem is there. That is why you are able to decide on the goal. Next, did you catch the bus, auto and walked up to the hermitage? Yes, that means you put individual efforts. You walked, you catch the bus, you caught the auto, and then you came up to the hermitage. This is all due to the individual efforts. And did people help you come to the hermitage by giving you the right directions? Yes, you got people's cooperation. So that is how success comes into your life. The success formula is very easy. First of all, have self-esteem, that is self-love. Next is have individual efforts. It is not sufficient if you just have self-love. You should put in your efforts. And if you just put in your efforts, it is not sufficient. You need people's cooperation. All the three things are required to become a successful individual. Otherwise, you will not see success in your life. If you just have self-esteem and you don't put individual efforts, and if people are not cooperating, you will not get success. So this is the SIP formula. Success, individual efforts, and people's cooperation. Without these three factors, success will never come. So this same boy became a pharmacist. And when he became a pharmacist, he started observing, discussing, thinking about how to improve the self-esteem. At that time, when he was discussing and thinking how to improve one's self-love or self-esteem, he came across two fantastic organizations. One was IPA, Indian Pharmaceutical Association. Second was KRPA, Karnataka Registered Pharmacists Association, and he joined them. And when he looked at the logo of the IPA, he was really puzzled because it had an interesting word, pranipatena, which means surrendering. Then pariprasnena, it means having the humble inquiry. That means you are having a spirit of inquiry, scientific inquiry, and sevaya, work service. So all these three components are there in this interesting quote, which has been taken from the Universal Song of the Divine. And the IPA, which is a national professional body of pharmacists, is engaged in many aspects of the profession of pharmacy. It has a fantastic vision that pharmacists of various facets of the profession of pharmacy should work for the highest professional and ethical standards. The mission is to increase the image and strengthen the image of the pharmacists as competent healthcare professionals, sensitize the community, government, and others on vital professional issues, and support the pharmaceutical education and sciences in all aspects. And that is what the IPA is doing, to promote pharmacy, to impart right education and training, to undertake and carry on scientific technical research, to publish various magazines, documents, to hold seminars, conferences. So when you join IPA, you become a part of an elite group of pharma professionals. So pharma professionals all are very, very thankful to IPA for strengthening the image as well as ensuring that they have got a very good future. You can get complimentary copies of Pharma Times as well as Indian Journal of Pharmaceutical Sciences. There are lots of awards and fellowships like the Professor M.L. Shroff Memorial Award and so on and so forth, which are offered by IPA. So there are several publications too for you to savor and improve your own well-being. So leading the IPA charge are Professor T.V. Narayana for the second time, and he is the president of IPA, national president, several other office bearers, as you can see here, their names. So definitely this is a very friendly organization. You should get in touch with it and become a member of IPA, which organizes the National Pharmacy Week during the third week of November every year to promote the profession, not only among pharmacists, but also towards other healthcare professionals. So what it's doing is the activity is collaborative in nature. However, there is one more thing which Dialogue Baba did not tell you. And there is some secret sauce which is responsible for every person's success. If you look at the three photographs here, you can see Dr. T.V. Narayana sir giving a very, very large beaming smile. Pramod sir also looking very happy, and a very shy smile sported by Dr. Salahuddin ji. Well, that smile is the secret ingredient, ladies and gentlemen, which all these three successful people are having, because they have understood that in the class photograph of the University of California Mills College, when the girls smiled genuinely, even after 30 years when their lives were tracked, these genuine smilers had happier lives in terms of marriage, well-being, and career. So smile is very important, because children smile at least 400 times a day. We feel happy when there are children. And partnering dentists and pharmacists to create a world full of healthy smiles and laughter is Group Pharmaceuticals with Cheyenne M. Freshclore. Avoid contact greetings. And of course, ensure that you do all the prevention, counseling as pharmacists to ensure best COVID-19 activity. Before I wrap up, I'll just go for this quiz. Let us see, ladies and gentlemen. I want the answers to come full of fire. Let it come fast. Yes, who is this? Who is this photograph? Please type in the chat. And we have got an exciting gift hamper which will be couriered to you as always. Please type the name of this person. Yes, I'm not seeing anybody's answer. Please type. Yes, Pramod Bhaskar Kumar, you're number one. Okay, fastest finger first is important. You have answered the question correctly. It is Dr. M.L. Shroff. Now, this was a sitter question. Now, let us see to the next question. That question is over. Now, we'll go to the next question. When was the first documented NPW, National Pharmacy Week of IPA? Let us see if anybody will answer that. When, which year was the first documented National Pharmacy Week? Please understand, a beautiful PDF document has been released by IPA under the head leadership of Dr. Narayana sir. And that actually gives a wealth of information. When was the first documented NPW of IPA? First documented, you have to give the year. 1982, wrong. Sayada, good try, not 1982. It goes much before that. You will be surprised to know. Much before that. No, not 90s, not even 80s. Very interesting answers are coming. But no, not 60. Third week of. No, not even 1983. Okay, 72. No, not 1952. 52 is too earlier. Okay, anybody giving the right answer? Let us see. 1984.
1962.
Sir, presenter should not answer. Presenter should not answer. Okay, thank you. 1962, somebody has given here. Let us see who is the person. Kamanand. Okay, right. I remember your name. So first we had Pramod, then we have Kamanand. Let me go to the next question. People should answer all the most questions and it should be fast. In India, where was the first B-Farm course started? Simple question. Where was the first B-Farm course started in India? Let us see who will answer. A presenter should not answer. Please. Where was the first B-Farm course started? Can I have the answers? Yes, 1960. Okay, BHU. Dr. Neeraj, thank you very much. You are the first to answer this question. BHU, yes, it is Benares Hindu University. It was a three-year course, by the way, at that time. Okay, next question. Where was the first ever pharmacy course introduced along with the medical course? Where was the first pharmacy course introduced along with the medical course? Let us see. Yes, Goa. Fatima is there. Goa. Now, each person has answered one question. So, it's making me difficult. And Pramod is the first one to get the first answer. So, he's right now leading in the table. Now, let us see the next tiebreaker. Let us see who is going to answer this. Yes, Varsha, Sharipul, everybody, the answer has been taken already. Last question, let us see. A popular English lady author of detective novels, she was also a qualified assistant pharmacist. So, there was a lot of poison being used in the characters of her novels. So, who is this lady novelist? Can anybody guess? See, all the characters use poison in her novels. She's a very popular international English novelist. Can you guess what is her name? Agatha Christie. Yes, Kulsum, Giridhar. Fantastic. Okay, I will take a call here. I will give three prizes. Okay, let me make a note of the names. I will give to three people. One is, we have got Dr. Neeraj. She has answered two questions, although it was a little late, but no problem. So I will give it to Pramod. I will give it to Dr. Neeraj. And I will give it to Kulsum. Okay, I made note of this. So you have to send me an email with your address and you will be getting that gift. Okay, by now everything has stabilized. So we can go to the main course of this presentation as well as the proceedings. A very remarkable personality is Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir. He is known to be a firebrand and a very dynamic leader. This time round, he has got a fantastic international award, and that's called as the 2020 FAPA, and that is the Ishi Date Award. I do not know the correct pronunciation. Maybe that is correct. So Ishi Date Award is provided by FAPA. FAPA is the Federation of Asian Pharmaceutical Associations. And Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, is one of the five Asian pharmacy professionals selected from the different categories for excellent contributions in pharmacy field. Congratulations, sir. I request fellow presenters also to clap. Thank you very much. And it was fantastic. Now, announcing the award winners, the chairperson of the awards committee, Dr. Yolando, said that these people have been selected for their exemplary services to different facets of our profession. And Dr. Narayana, sir, has to go to Kuala Lumpur in April 2021. So by then, everything will be over. Your COVID-19, everything will be over. So Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, will go to KLCC Convention Center. It is all predestined. COVID-19 should come down and Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, should go there to take the award. Fantastic, sir. You are blessed. So winners of other categories are Dr. Sue, Hazel, and so on and so forth, the names of whom you can see. And Dr. Narayana said, this is from the report from Chronicle Pharma Biz, that he is so happy that his services to IPA and pharmacy education have been recognized internationally. Definitely, sir, you are very inspiring. Dr. Narayana, sir, is the director of three pharmacy institutions, including at Rajahmundry, the Vikas College of Pharmacy, SBD Institute of Pharmacy in Bengaluru, and we have HLT College of Pharmacy in Ramnagara. He has been serving IPA for the past 30 years, and he has been honored with IPA Eminent Pharmacist Award. So everybody, including the Students Forum of IPA, have congratulated this firebrand dare-do leader, who is a rare blend of three things: academic excellence, entrepreneurship, and organizational and management skills. So this culmination of leadership quality has made him a very enthusiastic and firebrand personality in our pharmaceutical profession. In fact, he has done not only his B-Pharm, M-Pharm, but also M-Phil and PhD from Andhra University. He has been the state and national merit scholarship holder and is the winner of Sri B.V. Patel Trust Memorial Scholarship for securing the first seat in B.Pharm in Andhra University in 1980. He has 30 years of rich experience in the field of teaching, research, administration, and so many students will vouch for his honest support that he gives to the students and makes them come up in life. And hundreds of students I have met or listened to, I have not met, I have listened to, who have always talked in very good language regarding Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, for his immense contributions. So, Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, congratulations for having attended so many conferences, delivered so many orations, 100 scientific papers across the world, UK, Netherlands, Portugal, Turkey. I think you must be having a passport, which is, you know, like Encyclopedia Britannica, half of it. So you have won so many prizes also, as we can see here. It's a recognition to all the contributions that you have made. We honestly wish you a very, very long, continued and highly contributory life, sir. Thank you very, very much for being there for us. So Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Sunil, for the nice introduction. You made my work very easy. You briefed the people about IPA and all the activities. So we can say webinar Baba is Sunil Chiplankar. First of all, greetings from Indian Pharmaceutical Association and on my behalf and on behalf of Indian Pharmaceutical Association. And my heartfelt congratulations to IPA Mysuru branch, local branch, and also Group Pharma for organizing this National Pharmacy Week celebration. And my compliments particularly to Dr. Salahuddin, who is instrumental in organizing this program. And Dr. Pramod, who is organizing wonderful activities. I have attended some of his programs as a resource person, and Mr. Sunil Chaplankar. I think when my compliments to IPA Mysuru local branch for organizing our curtain raiser, first curtain raiser of National Farms Week, is this was the first one in India. I think just now we are also making arrangements at Rajahmundry local branch, where I was stationed here at Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences. So at 5 o'clock we are organizing the curtain raiser of NPW 2020. I think the credit should go to IPA Mysuru branch. You are the first in India to start the activities of NPW 2020. I think this is the best time because it is starting with guidance, with the blessings of His Holiness Swamiji of JSS Mata, and also with Salahuddin and Pramod, active members of this IPA branch. Anyhow, IPA activities, no need to brief. Already Sunil has given wonderful presentation about IPA, and I want to share with all you people, earlier days IPA is not that much visible and not having that much vibrant activities, but for the past 6 to 8 years, I can say it started from the tenure of Dr. Rao VSV Vadlamudi, who is my immediate past president of IPA. We have given a serious thought, let us go more visible to the society and more vibrant when compared with the previous people, with the help of all our institutions. So I think Dr. Rao has made a wonderful beginning, which is continued during my tenure. And IPA is not only visible at national level, because nowadays every national channel they started calling IPA. Earlier they are not bothered of IPA or any pharmacy organization. Now every channel is calling and every organization is coming forward. We want to associate with IPA. We want to organize this webinar and this activity. And like this, we are having 10 activities in loop line now. More than 20 activities we organized previously. And I'm very happy the way IPA is progressing at both national and international level. Even at international level also, IPA has been recognized, because of the recent victory of Manjiri Garath as a vice president of FIP. She got the highest number of votes when there were 4 contestants from US, UK and worldwide, and she got 61% of votes, highest number of votes she got, she won with thumping majority. And Dr. Rao Vadlamudi also again re-elected as a president of Commonwealth Pharmacists Association, representing 24 countries. And when IPA said we want our Dr. Rao to continue another term, all others has withdrawn and given unanimous, and elections were conducted for vice president post. That was the recognition IPA got at international. And again, I was elected as the president of Southeast Asian Regional Farm Forum, CR Farm Forum. I was there and we got an award at FAPA. These are all some of the achievements of IPA at international level. Now, FIP has also started recognizing the activities of IPA. And if you remember last time during the World Pharmacist Day, I briefed the members. Shortly, our Indian pharmacists are going to receive online training for vaccination program with the help of FIP. That's what we are planning. And in principle, it has been agreed and accepted by FIP. Shortly, by mostly from next month onwards, our pharmacists are going to receive online training program for vaccination. That's what we are going to play a crucial role in future. And so many activities and awards. Definitely IPA, we are recognizing the experts who rendered their services, and we are giving the awards even for students. ML Shroff gold medal, and KK Acharyaji gold medal, and Eminent Pharmacist Award, Lifetime Achievement Award. In addition to all these awards, we are encouraging students with IPA IRF scholarship. Total throughout India, we have identified 40 institutions, and each one student from first year, we are giving 25,000. That means every college, it started 4 years back. Now this year, we are giving almost 1 lakh to each college that means 40 lakhs. I can proudly say this is the only professional organization helping the students, poor and needy. It is not a meritorious. Whoever recommend, whatever the recommendation by the principal, it should go to the poor and needy. That's what JSS Pharmacy College is also one in that 40 colleges list. And that was the immense contribution of IPA to help the poor and needy students. Also, IPA to encourage the teachers. Earlier, we have introduced IPA ACG Award. That is Associated Capsules Group, thanks to Ajit Singh, who has announced 2 lakh prize money for this award. And one is Best Solid Dosage Forms Award. Even teachers can participate in this. The researchers can participate in this. Our M-Pharm students can participate in this. And Best Packaging Award to encourage the best packages or innovative packaging award. The prize money is 1 lakh, 1 lakh. Don't think that these awards are only for industry. Even our teachers can participate in this award. Coming to the National Pharmacy Week, it is the flagship activity of the Indian Pharmaceutical Association. I am proud to say it was first started in the year 1962 with a theme, Pharmacy as a Career. Because the purpose of National Pharmacy Week is to promote the image of pharmacist among us, the public, to create awareness among us, the society or public, there is a expert called pharmacist is available to serve you people. That was the main motto and the main opinion, interest of the Indian Pharmaceutical Association to focus the image of pharmacist as competent healthcare professional. And this NPW salute to the leaders of IPA earlier days, 1962, they have come out with this activity called National Pharmacy Week. This is the 59th National Pharmacy Week. Every year we are coming with a theme to promote the theme in that particular area. And generally, earlier days, it was organized during the third week of November. But last year onwards, during my tenure, we decided, let us do this throughout the year. It is, was not restricted to a particular week or third week. It starts in the month of November and colleges can organize the activities throughout the year. Because once you say, just organize one, they will organize and they will forget. It was not the motto. We want to promote this throughout the year or at least 6 months with the help of the institutions. Again, I should thank the students of various pharmacy colleges throughout country and principals and teachers who are supporting this noble cause and organizing NPW in a bigger way. And we are very happy we have come out with a clear-cut document, activity guide, that's called NPW Activity Guide, which was widely circulated throughout the country, and it was posted on our IPA website also. It gives clear-cut message to all the organizers, what are the things to do, not to do. What are the material? We have prepared the leaflets. We have prepared the material also. So everything is ready-made available. You can download from the website and you can promote the activities of National Pharmacy Week. That's what I want to request all the principals and the students on this platform. Once again, I want to just give you the information that we have come out with some competitions during this National Pharmacy Week. That competition is for registered pharmacists. That competition is for teachers and students also. We are going to give them a good amount of prize money and record participation. More than 2,000 participations we have received in this competition. Again, that was the record number and compared with previous years. So I am very happy with the way IPA is, NPW team is organizing, coming out with the material and promoting this. In this regard, I want to congratulate the team, NPW National Pharmacy Week team, headed by Dr. Manjari Garath, who is the Vice President of IPA and also Chairman of the Community Pharmacy Division, Manjari Garath, and her team, and also IPA Students Forum. This time, the students were maximum involved in this NPW, and they are the key people in designing this activity guide. That's what we are very happy. The students also participating in a bigger way. And because I believe strongly, they are our future leaders of the profession. We want to mold the students who can guide this profession in direction, right direction down the line after our tenure. That's what I believe it. And this time the theme is pharmacists, a frontline workforce professional. This was the theme of NPW 2020. Pharmacists are frontline health professionals. Why I am giving all these things is, so many years has gone, still the pharmacy has been not recognized by the society. What we expect to, earlier when compared with doctors, when compared with lawyers, when compared with chartered accountants and all these professionals, what we feel, I feel personally, we are not getting that much recognition from the society. Why means the pharmacists who are employed here, are most of them are diploma in pharmacists, and most of the diploma in pharmacists are not available in the community pharmacy where they have a direct access with the society. That was the reason the value, there is no value added services provided to the society also by our pharmacists. We should not blame our pharmacists, because the curriculum is designed like that. The good old year 91, still we are teaching them. The good old inorganic chemistry, organic chemistry, pharmaceutics 1, pharmaceutics 2 for the diploma holders. And 9 lakh diploma in pharmacists are working in a community pharmacy where they have a huge area to promote our profession throughout the country. We are the highest number when compared with any other developed country. But unfortunate, our diploma in pharmacy professionals are not equipped to promote or take this challenge to promote the image of pharmacists. But thanks to Dr. B. Suresh, again, President Pharmacy Council of India, who has come out with year 2021. Because again, I was there as a celebrities committee member in year 2021, when Professor Mani was the chairman of that committee, year 2011. And it was in KLE College of Pharmacy, Bangalore. I was there. We designed the syllabus, wonderful syllabus. Exactly fit the requirement and role of our pharmacist in future. There, the student is not going to study unnecessary subjects. Only he will be studying about patient counseling, drug-drug interactions, adverse drug reactions, and law, pharmacy laws. What are the laws? What is the inspection procedure? And what are the forms available to start a medical, to start a pharmacy? And so many aspects were included about pathophysiology the pharmacist is going to study in this new syllabus. Wonderful syllabus has come out for the diploma holders. And definitely, the services we are going to render to the society are going to be recognized in future, where our pharmacist image will be there in future. That's what I want to request on this platform to our working pharmacists. And we should feel proud. During this COVID-19, almost all the sectors were closed. All the sectors except pharmacy sector. Pharmacy is the first sector to start functioning right from the first week of this COVID-19 lockdown. If you take the history, no other sector has started first as the pharmacy sector. 9 lakhs pharmacies were opened throughout day and night throughout India. 2 lakh pharmacists started working in industry and making the drugs available to the society. And 60,000 pharmacy teachers started taking online classes, keeping the pharmacy students busy. And more than 2,000 regulators, both central and state, worked day and night and seeing that the drugs are available to the common public, particularly the life-saving drugs for life-saving diseases. 50,000 hospital pharmacists started working during this COVID-19 in various hospitals. So overall, 12 lakh people, more than 12 lakh pharmacists working right from the day one of the COVID-19, which is the highest number when compared with any other healthcare professional. We should feel proud that we are pharmacists. Doctors are hardly 6 lakhs throughout India, and nurses are 8 lakhs, and police personnel, other bureaucrats, and all within 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs. But we are 12 lakh pharmacists started working day one. That was the service we are giving to the society. So now, at least the society is going to recognize the services of pharmacists. That's what I am confident. If you take some of the examples during this COVID-19, the average deaths till today due to COVID-19 is 1,25,000 only. That was the data up to today's death rate due to COVID-19 is 1,25,000. If you take the deaths due to non-communicable diseases average per year, it is 2.5 million. If the drugs are not made available to the common people suffering with non-communicable diseases, the deaths may be much, much higher than the deaths due to COVID. Pharmacy. That's what I want to just brief our members here. And during this COVID-19, the hospitalization has come less because WHO has given clear-cut report. 40% of deaths are due to medication errors. The intervention of pharmacists reduced the deaths to 25%. That was the data given by WHO. That was the, what happened exactly, because when during the COVID-19, when the senior citizens and people with small ailments not able to go to hospital, they used to approach the pharmacist and take the advice of the pharmacist and they used to take the medicine. That's why the death rates are very less when compared with the regular death rates during this COVID-19 period and lockdown. That was the statistical data. That was again the immense contribution of the pharmacist to the society. Now, every senior citizen and every member of the society, they started recognizing the pharmacist during this COVID-19. That was the blessing in disguise, I can say. That was the one of the golden opportunity. We being a pharmacist, we got it. We have to prove now how best we can promote the image of our pharmacist, how best we can give value-added services to the society. This was the one of the wonderful opportunity given, and we have to prove it. For that, this NPW is the wonderful platform. We can promote at rural areas, rural villages, where they are not accessible to the essential medicines. Tell the importance of this. Tell the importance of non-communicable diseases. Tell the importance of the role of the pharmacist. That's how we can project the image of our pharmacist. That's what I want to appeal to all our principals, teacher friends and students to promote the image of the pharmacist during this National Pharmacy Week. And I am confident that all the IPA state branches and local branches, because I have seen so many programs of the state branches and local branches, they all are actively participating in this, taking the help of the students, and came out with various activities and with using the NPW materials. So once again, I thank all the state branches, local branches, and I thank all the pharmacy institutions across the country who have come forward, particularly the principal and the staff and the students, to promote the image of pharmacists, to organize various activities during this NPW. So with these few words of introduction, I congratulate once again the IPA Mysuru local branch team, and particularly Dr. Pramod Sanaulla, and also I thank Group Pharma, particularly Sunil Chiplankar, for the wonderful inauguration curtain raiser of this NPW 2020. And you have given three prizes to three participants. I think there are total five or six. So IPA will give the prizes to remaining three.
We will give. All identified people will be given the
prize. Even IP also want to share with the organizers. We will also encourage the participants, and it is the movement how we can promote, how we can recognize ourselves first, how we can respect each other. That's what I want to say on this platform. Once again, I thank the organizers for giving me the opportunity. I wish you all success. And once again, congrats to Pramod Sanaulla and Sunil Chiplankar for your wonderful efforts in organizing this NPW 2020.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. As they say, some of the people, when they come, they bring in tremendous energy to the entire system. So here today through IPA, you have given tremendous energy to all the pharmacy professionals, whether they are in academia or industry or regulatory or whichever dimension they are in. Thank you very much, sir, for empowering us. And we require your patronage on a continued basis. Now, definitely. I will go to the next part of this presentation. And it's my great pleasure to introduce Dr. Pramod Kumar, sir. As Dr. Narayana, sir, was reiterating, Dr. Pramod Kumar, sir, is one of the most important and a very energizing kind of a personality. Principal of JSS College of Pharmacy and Dean Faculty of Pharmacy at JSS AHER Mysuru. Dr. Pramod sir has over 27 to 30 years of teaching and research experience, where he has guided 60 MPharm students, 9 PhD candidates, and currently 6 PhD scholars, including from the industry. They are all under Dr. Pramod sir. So that is a tremendous contribution. He has more than 150 research articles which have been published in national and international journals. He has presented his research findings in international fora like the International Pharmaceutical Federation, as well as in DUFAT, which is in Dubai, and ISPOR, which was in USA. So his presentation has also been accepted, and he has presented in FIP 2003 Sydney, Australia. He has gone to Switzerland for making another presentation of his research work. JSS University has also deputed him for a WHO training program in Colombo. So he is teaching the faculty of pharmacy there in various aspects. He was the guest of honor at the AGM of the Pharmaceutical Society of Sri Lanka. So he has a tremendous line of activity, particularly the awards that he has won are a testimony to his activities. Now I request if Dr. Pramod sir is there to please come on live in by putting on his video. Is Dr. Pramod sir there, or is there some issue with this video link? Dr. Pramod sir? Yes, please. Welcome, yeah, sir, Dr. Pramod.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, sir.
You are audible. Yeah, very much. Yeah, thank you very much, Sunil. First of all, I'm doing the IPA National Student Team accepting being with us and giving all the necessary inputs and video, if that is okay.
Please continue, sir.
Yeah, I think the with video. All that I could say is Dr. T.V. Narayana is a very big source of information for all of us, and he's been always encouraging for all pharmacy and education, and all is a testimony for what professional he is, and then that he's a very good human being as well, and he is very passionate about the pharmacy profession, which has really you can make out to the brochures and the information leaflets that he has developed, which is very, very colorful and very professional, unlike the other years, which were something like black and white or Eastman color thing. But here he has really used a very graphics and put the people on job and got the things done in a very professional manner, and the theme is very apt, particularly when we say pharmacists, the frontline healthcare health professionals, because of the COVID pandemic, where many of our colleagues are working in as a frontline. Though when we say by definition frontline, it is doctors, nurses, physiotherapy, and others comes in the mind, but not the pharmacists. So though they are something like a playback singers, where they are doing their services silently, when whole, as Dr. T.V. Narayana narrated, that when whole of the country came to a lockdown, it was the pharmacists who were in a big number and who supported the healthcare system. It is not the doctors, it is not the nurses, it is not the police. So certainly we have a lot of high respects for our frontline pharmacy friends. And that was a very, very difficult time because they did not have the personal protection equipment, and there was no proper mention of the face mask during the initial period. And in spite of all these adversaries, still they were able to do and particularly support the elderly patients to whom the medicines were delivered to their respective houses, like home medication review. They saw to it that they do all these services and without caring for themselves or their family members. So they have did wonderful service. And last time also, Dr. T.V. Narayana has said, and he has re-emphasized this time also, that pharmacists would be trained for, say, giving the vaccination. It is, I think, a boon that any pharmacist would love to do. First is we need to be properly trained, and then I think it is going to be a wonderful experience for all of us. And because the pharmacists are silently serving the patients in the background, and they are not in the forefront, many times we miss the opportunity, what was supposed to be the recognition that is supposed to be given. And I'm very happy to say that some of our colleagues are a part of this vaccine trials, which are meant for the COVID-19. We have a complete phase 2 and phase 3 in JSS hospital. And even I was a volunteer for one of the vaccines. So it means that already doctors and other healthcare professionals.
There is some internet issue, technical aspect there. Kindly bear with us. So Dr. Pramod Kumar sir was elaborating on the role of the pharmacist, not only in the services provided in the community level.
They are equally.
Yes, continue, sir. Now your audio is clear.
This is the only branch where all the pharmacy colleges and all the other association comes on one platform and then celebrate it. So this is a very unique thing. And this could not have been happened without the support of all the organization heads, presidents, and principals of all the colleges. And it is not just the pharmacists at the community and hospital. It is also the pharmacists who are working in the industry. They work without any taking any rest and all, and they could support supplying all the necessary medicines where the country could even supply the medicines to more than 125 countries as well. So I think it is a wonderful thing that we should be cherishing. And as it was told, it is not limited only to the National Pharmacy Week for 1 week in the third week of November. We can celebrate under this banner throughout the year. I think it is a wonderful experience. And as a part of IPA, we have also chalked down number of programs. And because of COVID pandemic, our Vice President Dr. Salahuddin would brief you that we have planned a lot of online activities, and nothing can stop. Even COVID cannot stop our activities. We are going to prove that it is wrong, that the singing competition will happen, rangoli competition will happen, photography competition will happen, dance competition will happen. COVID will be getting disturbed, thinking that I thought that everything is going to be hard, but how things are not, things are still going on. So I think again, thanks to COVID, that it has given us opportunity to take the activities in a different manner. And in a similar manner, even our JSS University is also promoting all this online cultural fest we are celebrating. So that is also being held. We would be having more number of activities. And we have an amazing team here, and without which we could not have performed all these different activities like health camps, then marathons, walking, and also the blood donation camp. Many different activities simultaneously we would be doing. And all this would be a part of the thing. And wherever it is possible, we would certainly follow the government advisories of face mask and social distancing and all, and still cater to the mandate of what IBA is looking at. And we would be really going ahead with and saying that we are there with you, and we will tell the society, we will tell the public that here are the healthcare professionals who are with you, and to consider us also as a frontline health professionals. I once again thank Group Pharma, Sunil Chaplankar, then Dr. Salahuddin and Dr. Chandan to put all these things together. I had three devices with three different internets, but still somehow it was not really working good with me. And but still, I was able to make it. Thank you once again for all these activities, and we wish that we would have a wonderful activities in future. Thank you once again.
Thank you very, very much, Dr. Pramod sir. Despite all the, that is how triumphant pharmacists are always. Thank you so much, and we will now move on to Dr. Salahuddin sir. So it is indeed a great pleasure for me to introduce Dr. Salahuddin sir, born in Raichur in 1976, who completed his B.Pharm, M.Pharm, Ph.D. from VL College of Pharmacy, Raichur. Yes, hello.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, we can hear you, Dr. Salahuddin ji.
Okay.
Right. So as I was saying, he is a very unique personality, and his experience has rubbed on to his personality. He is one of the few pharmacists who is a marketing pharmacist, I should say, because he started his life as a medical representative in iconic companies like Glenmark and Bayer Limited. He then worked as a product manager, which is a very good posting, in Microlabs Bangalore for about 1.5 years. So he had a good exposure to the marketing concept, including the manufacturing areas, because through marketing, you get in touch to all these industrial operations. And he was responsible for launching successfully three new products from Microlabs Carcion division. So that is a feather in his cap. Then he started his domestic academic life, where he went on to become a lecturer at MESCO College of Pharmacy. Then he went to VL College of Pharmacy as a lecturer, assistant professor. And now he has come down to Farukia College of Pharmacy. Right from 2010, he is working both as a professor and a principal at this college. He has also got a stint in foreign academic life, where he has worked in Libya at a university. He has done a lot of work, not only by collecting the grants from the government, but also he has done research work for DRDO, which is a big feather in his cap, Defense Research Development Organization. He has 2 patents registered in his name and 29 publications with a cumulative impact factor of 7.63. He is an approved guide of M.Pharm and PhD, and he has supervised many students, not only in India, but also PG students abroad in Libya. He has chaired many sessions in conferences as a poster evaluator also, and he has served as an examiner. He has been the chairman of the Board of Studies in Pharmacy of RGUHS, Academic Council member. He has got many important posts, including in the BOS of Yenapoya University. He is a true leader, because you can see his facet in different organizations, as you can see here listed, both at various levels of society. So he's excellent in relationship management too. He's been with Farukia College, which is the second oldest college in Mysore, and they offer D-Pharm, B-Pharm, Pharm-D, Pharm-D post-baccalaureate, PhD, and so on. So it's a well-known college, and we congratulate him for getting this Best Pharma Leader Award at Pharma Vision 2025 with respect to that. With respect to Pharma Vision 2025, he was given the award on 27 September 2020. So he has won a lot of encomiums for his dynamic role in the field of pharmacy, in society, in continuing pharmacy education, in induction programs, and so on and so forth. So these pictures speak a volume. They say a picture speaks 1,000 words. So no point in me describing all these pictures. Once you see it, you get a chance to understand what an elegant picture of achievement he is. Congratulations, Dr. Salahuddin ji, for the fantastic achievements that you have done both in India, abroad, empowering pharmacists and encouraging the growth of pharmaceutical profession. No, it's all over to you, Dr. Salahuddin ji. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sunil Chiplankar sir, for a nice introduction and for making me part of this wonderful evening of the Curtain Raiser for the 59th National Pharmacy Week celebration. I cannot say how best is and feeling and admiration to being part of this, because you are not only God, the students of the freshers, because most of the attendees are the pharmacists who has chosen this as a profession. And the second most important thing is that you have got our national president, Dr. T.V. Narayana, on this platform. I say that it is Sone Pe Suhaga. Okay, having such a wonderful person, and we are talking about the National Pharmacy Week. Respected Dr. T.V. Narayana, sir, the president of the Indian Pharmaceutical Association, respected Dr. Pramod Kumar, sir, the president of the Mysuru IPA brand, Sunil Chiplankar, sir, the vice president of the Group Pharmaceuticals Bangalore, my fellow friend, Dr. Chandan, the secretary of the IPA, and also we are supposed to have Dr. Kaushik, the president of the Karnataka Registered Pharmacists Association. First of all, greetings from me to all of you. Happy Pharmacist Day, happy Pharmacist Week to all of you. And as I was telling to many of the students, see, we celebrate the festivals. There will be always festivals for everyone. But for pharmacists, there are two festivals we have to remember. One is the World Pharmacist Day, that will be celebrated on the 25th September. And the second is the National Pharmacy Week, which we will be celebrating from the third week of the November. This year, we will be celebrating from 16th November to the 21st November. Hats off, a big thank you to Dr. T.V. Narayana. As Dr. Pramod Kumar sir has already said, for the first time, a blueprint has been released by the IPA, which clearly gives and defines what actually the role of the pharmacist is, what actually pharmacist needs to do it. In fact, whatever Dr. Sunil Chiplankar has put into the rapid fire questions, all those questions you are going to get it from this blueprint. And this blueprint gives you right from 1962 to till date how best the pharmacist week has been celebrated by the IPA. I don't want to say much of the things, because Dr. T.V. Narayana has already highlighted that how the healthcare professionals during this pandemic has played a very vital role. There was a huge manpower, the pharmacists who were playing, the community pharmacists, the hospital pharmacists, the industry pharmacists, even the regulatory pharmacists and hospital pharmacists, all they were playing a vital role. Put together, as stated, 12 lakh pharmacists were working. When the lockdown has occurred, there was only one profession, that is 12 lakh people, 24/7 was working to see that how they can protect the life of the people, how they can improve the healthcare system of the country, how they can prevent the untoward effects of the disastrous effect of this virus, how it can be prevented from it, and without thinking about their own risk of life. I always said, I'm also saying in many of the platforms, pharmacist is just not pharmacist, it is a masiha. In fact, before starting of this webinar, Dr. Sunil Chiplankar has played one of the song which was been sung by one of the pharmacists as a singer only. So it was said that it was masiha is dunya mein logon ka masih. Masih means it is the one kind who is going to give the protection to the people. Is dunya mein logon ka masih dur karne ke liye bebasi. We are the pharmacists. That is what he has put on the song. What are the pharmacists are doing? They are the masihas. Masihas in every region, as Dr. T.V. Narayana sir has said, the regulatory, in the industry, in the community, they are all playing their different roles. We have seen their actual roles. In fact, the purpose of conducting of National Pharmacy Week is to make people aware what services are being rendered by the pharmacists. Though we are doing it at the backdrop, we are always playing the behind the role. We are not at the front line. Though the government of India has declared the frontline workers are going to get 50 lakh insurance during this COVID time. In that time also, when the dossier was being prepared, the pharmacist's name was missing. That means we have been not highlighted much. But now it is our time. It is our responsibility to that how best we can propagate it. The documentary that was released by the IPA, which clearly gives that what activity you need to do in the whole week from the 16th of November to the 21st of November to make aware people that what pharmacists are doing it. So people have realized the responsibilities and the jobs being done by the pharmacists during the lockdown period. But still, we have to do it. We from the IPA, even from the Mysore headquarters, we have done a lot of activities over the last 4 years. As Dr. Trim Pramod Kumar has said, it was the IPA, Indian Pharmaceutical Association, to this branch. We have all come onto one platform and celebrate. We carry out a lot of activities, and the activities that includes the singing competition. This year also, it was a thought how we are going to conduct it. It's a lockdown time. The students are not available. Many of the students who are studying in Mysore city are from either from Kerala or from the Northeast or from the Tamil Nadu. We cannot invite them for the competition, but this did not hamper our the confidence level of going ahead to conduct this National Pharmacy Week. Dr. Chandan will also highlight more on this. We are going to conduct, there will be a lot of competitions like singing, debate, there will also be a dance competition. All these things are going to be through this virtual mode, through the digital mode. Being sitting at room, at home, you people can perform your activity. You can be live, you can present it. Our flagship activities used to be, we had, as sir was telling, blood donation camp, health screening camp, and we used to have a mega rally, pharma rally, which I think these are certain things I think we may not be able to do it because there is a restriction from the government, but still we are contemplating it to look forward to at least carry out blood donation and health screening. Pharma rally may not be possible, but press briefing and press update, we are going to do it. This is part of it. And these are all we are going to do it through the placards. The IPA has given a blue and white complete documentary to which in what way it can be carried out. The best thing they have said is that reach out to the people, update to them. I always said that our pharmacy profession is our profession. But this profession has been hijacked by many of the people. If you see in the community pharmacies we don't see in many of the regions, in many of the places, because they have been hijacked by the traders. Now here it becomes the responsibility of the community pharmacists to see that you want to get the value. Though the face value of the pharmacist, when we call about pharmacy profession, people immediately think about the community pharmacy, the medical store person or the pharmacy store person. It is now the responsibility of the community pharmacist to take, see that their specialty, their job, which has been hijacked by the traders, have been taken back and it has been brought back to the quality. In few of the themes of the IPA, which was given earlier, the safety of medications, ask your pharmacist, all these things were there because the pharmacist was not pharmacist, it was a trader. Now, with this IPS activity over the last 4 or 5 years, as Dr. T.V. Narayana sir was telling, the much of the awareness has started. IPA has created a lot of awareness and the public are getting a lot of information about the role of pharmacists through various means of activities. And this is one such activity, this is one such week where all the information has been percolated down, we bring it out and we update it to the general public about the roles of the pharmacists. Now in the community pharmacy, we have to get back. We have to get into the action, get update to the knowledge. I appreciate to the Maharashtra State Pharmacy Council for carrying out the wonderful activity where they have empowered the pharmacists. Though the 2015 PPR regulations, PCI has itself has given the power to the pharmacists, where now the pharmacist has the right even to substitute the prescription. These powers, whatever we are getting it, we should utilize it and still create more awareness and the value to the pharmacist. And as I was telling about the Maharashtra State Pharmacy Council, there the prescription will not be dispensed until and unless the patient is being identified that properly is being medication is given or not. The same thing I feel every state pharmacy council, if takes into action, and the drug regulators, definitely pharmacist value is going to be innumerous shortage in our country. Though it has been notified that there are around 12 lakh workforce is there in our India. This is not going to be sufficient enough to cater to the services of our country. We need many more. In the last lecture, Dr. T.V. Narayana sir has said by 2030, there will be a shortage of 20 to 30 billion jobs of healthcare professionals as per FIP. And amongst these healthcare professionals, there will be a huge requirement of pharmacists. In order to fulfill this requirement, I think the present generation to get prepared yourself to grab these opportunities and create the value about the pharmacists. This is what I wanted to say. Even in the industry, in fact, during this lockdown period, I got an opportunity to have been in one of the webinar wherein we have deliberated that what actually and where it is hampering the pharmacist roles. And it has been found that in one such rule of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act 7176 and 142, which has permitted the non-professionals to be as employer, to be as an employee in the industry, pharmaceutical industry. This is one rule which has to be amended. And I request through this platform to Dr. T.V. Narayana sir also to please take up that how best these amendments can be brought in into the Drugs and Cosmetics Act, which makes it mandatory that only pharmacists should be employed even in the pharmaceutical industry. When I was talking about hijacking of the profession, even the profession is being hijacked, even in the industry. Now more than the pharmacists, the MSc people are working in the pharmaceutical industry. Here I feel is that they need to be amended to this Drugs and Cosmetic Act so that many of them will get the job opportunities. And I just wanted to say that in many of the instances, pharmacists are playing role. Some of them may not be entitled, as you all know that the pharmacist is not entitled to write the prescription, but still they have become the masiha. I have seen in many of the instances in North India, if I go to particular regions where even approach of the normal healthcare professional is very difficult, in such places, it was the pharmacist who was playing the excellent role as a healthcare professional. They are really the masihas in those positions. And teachers, during this lockdown period, they have played excellent role. And the profession which has got modified, which has excelled and bringing up the quality, with the bringing up of the 2008 PharmD regulations, has given a lot more power. We were working behind the scenes. We were behind the scenes. We were never in touch with the doctors. With the amendment and availability of the PharmD, now the pharmacists are working shoulder to shoulder with the doctors and healthcare professionals. And I must say, the confidence level that doctors are having on the pharmacists is more than the pharmacists having on the pharmacists. So this is what the pharmacists are playing role. And I feel that through this platform, each one of you should take pledge that we, as a pharmacist, we will bring the name and glory to the profession always. We always work ethically and always dedicatively only to the pharmacy profession. And if we take this pledge, I'm sure the pharmacists who are all now joining hands over here, the freshers who might have come over here to this profession by chance, I'm sure it should become a choice for them. So please see that you are going to be part of it from 16th to 21st of November. Though it is there from the national, the Mysore IPA branch is going to also announce the shortly the activities for the National Pharmacy Week, to which Secretary Dr. Chandan will also speak on that. And with this, all regarding the speaking of the National Pharmacy Week, I would like to conclude with a share that both to all the people, I'm sure that encouragement is most important, and we as a team member working is also very important. So my share is that mushkilon mein bhag jana aasan hota hai, har pehlu zindagi ka imtihan hota hai, darne walon ko milta nahi kuch zindagi mein, ladne walon ko khatmon mein pura jahan hota hai. That means if you are strong enough, even you can bring back the glory of the profession. So please do try to see that always you stick to the ethics, try to acquire more knowledge and skill so that you are going to be more confident to deliver the best services as a pharmacist, as a community pharmacist, as a clinical pharmacist, as a hospital pharmacist, or as an industry pharmacist as a regulator or as an academic pharmacist. So with this, I would like to conclude. I would like to thank Dr. Sunil Chiplankar for giving me an opportunity to be part of this through his platform of the Group Pharmaceuticals. I also thank to our IPA Mysuru branch president, Dr. T.M. Pramod Kumar, for accepting to our request to conduct this webinar. And a big thank you to the national president of the IPA, Dr. T.V. Narayana, with just one call. When I said that, sir, we wanted to plan this, the webinar for the curtain result to the National Pharmacy Week 59th, he just said, okay, I'm going to attend. This commitment and the dedication which Dr. T.V. Narayana has is we all required to take up and go ahead to conduct a wonderful way of the National Pharmacy Week. With this, I conclude. Thank you, Sunil Chiplankar, sir. And I also thank to all the attendees for listening patiently to my lecture. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much. That was a very fiery speech. Eh? And I should say you are epitome of that saying, Jo Jita Vahi Sikandar. So you are really on rocket fuel. You gave a very good emotionally charged speech, which actually helped us realize the direction in which we need to work to enhance our own status within the society and get the acknowledgement for all the corona war efforts that we are doing. Along with the industry professionals, marketing pharmacists are also there who are doing a fantastic job trying to touch base with the doctors, chemists, pharmacists, and ensure the availability and promotion of the product. So it is indeed my great pleasure now to introduce Dr. Chandan sir. When I looked at Dr. Chandan sir, who is a B-Pharm, M-Pharm, and PhD, his biodata, it was very interesting. The only thing that came to my mind was he is a textbook man. Look at the number of textbooks he has published. Textbook of Instrumental Methods of Analysis for Final Year B-Pharm, another one on Medicinal Chemistry, another textbook for the fifth semester in Medicinal Chemistry, and so on. It is not easy to write a textbook. Even he was saying that this lockdown helped him to focus on writing a textbook. So that's awesome. I think we should all learn that. Please observe his book on Textbook of Instrumental Methods of Analysis for Final Year B-Pharm, seventh semester, was published in September 2020. So he has constructively used this lockdown period to write a textbook. So I think that is a signal for all fellow professionals. He is a recipient of several travel grants. He has gone to Dubai for presentation of his papers. He has gone again on a travel grant to Bangkok. He has won the Best Poster Award in Manipal, and he has also got the gold medal for Best Outgoing Student in M-Pharma at JSS UT. So Dr. Chandan sir has got many more feathers in his cap, but because of the time constraint, I will not be able to give full highlight of his profile. Dr. Chandan sir, all over to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. So good evening all. So it's an honor to be the team of IPA Mysore local branch to be the for the curtain raiser.
I think they are experiencing some amount of internet trauma. Maybe there is a virus going around in the internet which is causing their sluggish internet thing. So Dr. Chandan sir basically is going to emphasize as a secretary what are all his duties as well as the closing remarks for today's presentation by Dr. T.V. Narayana sir, as well as Dr. Pramod and Dr. Salahuddin ji. Dr. Chandan sir, could you join back?
Yes, sir, because of some internet issues.
Yeah, please.
So anyway, so it's our pleasure from the IPM Mysore branch to organize this 59th National Pharmacy Week, because all my president as well as vice president has already briefed like the various activities which we are planning, which is under the due process, which we'll be doing it. As we previous years, we used to do the pharma rally, blood donation camp, and all other literary activities and lecture from the alumni. But since because of this COVID issues and as well as the state regulations and all, so which we are planning everything in the terms of the online. So even the cultural activities, like it may be the singing or the dance.
Yeah, I think there is a disturbance again. So I will request Dr. Chandan sir when he comes back, because it's going to be like a wave. When the wave hits back the shore, he will be back again. So when he comes back, you try to make it shorter, because you will be going on and off. The internet is very fickle in your place. And it is... now are you there, Dr. Chandan?
What Dr. Chandan wanted to say is that we have planned some 7 to 8 activities. One is the debate competition, which will be conducted online. And participants now, since it is online, we are expecting it can be from any place of the country. Anybody can participate. We will be circulating it to the various social medias. You can participate. There will be a singing competition. You can participate live into the singing competition. There will be a dance. This is not going to be a live. You have to record your video and you have to send it, that video, to the Google Drive, and from there we will download, and the participants, the best participant, the best performer is going to get the prize for that. And drawing competition will be there. You have to draw and you have to submit. And photography competition is also going to be there. The photography, some rules and regulations will be there, that all the flyers are going to come. And we had one of the best flagship activity which we started last year, that is Gata Rahe Mera Dil. Here we invite the pharmacists, the pharma singers, and there is no language barrier over here, that you can sing in any language, but you should be a good singer. You should not be a bathroom singer. If you are a good singer, you can participate. And that's what our flagship activity, Gata Rahe Mera Dil. Last year we started, it was initiated because here at Mysore, doctors are doing it as Doctor's Day, for during the Doctor's Day, as Geet Gata Chal. And we thought of that we can also have it, and there was a good demand for that program. And through that program, doctors got more mileage to it. And we also thought that by conducting such type of programs, the pharmacists should get more mileage. The intention is that our publicity as a pharmacist, people should know what actually we people are playing the role. So that is what Dr. Chandan wanted to say. I hope many more you wanted to add. But as far as the IPA Mysuru has been concerned, as a curtain raiser today, we wanted to inform to all the people that you all have attended from the local institutions, try to see that you participate and win the maximum prizes. Definitely, this is a competition, but more of an enjoyment. So try to take this enjoyment and have a great time.
Thank you very much, Dr. Salahuddin ji, for completing what was left unsaid.
Hello.
As such, have you come back, Dr. Chandan? Many points were made, which probably you wanted to say also by Dr. Salahuddin ji. Since time is short, I request you to add a few points and wrap it up. Please, Dr. Chandan.
Hello.
Yes, Dr. Chandan, can you hear me? Well, I think Dr. Chandan's internet is still having a problem. So we will go ahead. Hello? So we will proceed with the next item in the agenda. So we have representing KRPA here, Dr. Shilpa Madam, and she will be proposing the vote of thanks. At this juncture, I recollect what actually Dr. Salahuddin ji and he had discussed. We thought there is a saying, you know, it's easy to conceive and difficult to deliver. So when I just said that the IPA document is very good and that good curtain raiser will be a very interesting point, he immediately took on the idea, and then very good session we have had till now. Thank you very much, Dr. Salahuddin ji, for being the sutradhar for today's session, and I request Dr. Shilpa Madam to take over. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. First of all, it was a very good opportunity for all of us to participate in this. And it is a curtain raiser, of course, for all of us to celebrate the National Pharmacy Week. And I am here representing both the KRPA as well as IPA. I'm also the executive committee member of IPA. So I, on behalf of Chandan sir also, I would request all the members to kindly participate in all the activities which the IPA Mysuru branch is conducting, and we will be announcing in a very large event, and we expect more of participants to be there. Coming to this particular session, it was a great session we had. It was initially the eye opener is always our moderator, sir. He is always a great motivator for any webinar to start with, and he always has a new innovative things to tell us. So today it was a webinar guru. So thank you so much, sir. Seeing you only, we feel that motivation. So it is very nice to have you. Thank you so much, sir, for being here. And we had a great opportunity to have the IPA president, T.V. Narayan, sir. He has been, I would express that he is a person who is representing the newer or the modern pharmacy which is coming in, because he is always trying to bring in something new to happen. And in his speech, he also expressed that he wants the pharmacist to be get trained for vaccination. So that is a great thing. I think the Western countries pharmacists are really having this opportunity. And now if our pharmacist offers this, then I think we have achieved something in our own profession. So that was great. And I really thank Dr. T.V. Narayan, sir, being a part, and also he was the main person for the curtain raiser. So I thank very much for his time and his appreciation words as well. We had our principal, Dr. T.M. Pramod Kumar, sir, who's always been a motivating person. Anything, any new thing which we want to do, he's always there to support and tell us that, yes, we can do it. Why not? Why we let us be the first to do it? So that motivation is there. And thank you very much, sir, Pramod, sir. Your time and your with all the technical which happened today, but still you could make it for us. Thank you so much. Salahuddin sir is another great person we have in our IPA team. He's there to support all the activities with his great enthusiastic, and the first we always like is this shayari mode which keeps us more interesting. So thank you so much, Salahuddin sir. And you also briefed that there are so many responsibilities that pharmacists should take in as different roles what we play today. So that was really eye-opener. It should be taken seriously. And in this celebration more, we should always think that every new thing we should express, and we should be forward to give our services as pharmacists. So thank you so much, sir, for being part of this and telling us. Dr. Chandan, sir, he's a member secretary for IPA. Always, he's a very meticulous person, doing all his work very organized way, and that's how the events also gets organized very well. And thank you very much, sir. On behalf of you, we Salahuddin sir, his all the ideas which you have brought it down, but and yeah. It was nice having you in this event. I think everything went on very organized, and we are very happy, KRPA and also the IPA Mysore branch with the Group Pharmaceuticals. We thank you so much for organizing such an event and bringing all the pharmacists together. I take this opportunity to thank one and all. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Have a nice National Pharmacy Week celebrations. Yes. Many documents are there for downloading, PDF documents. I request all attendees, including that NPW document is there. So I have the permission, I think, of all the presenters to put close to this webinar. Can I close, sirs?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes,
thank you very much. Thank you.